I'm happy to be here, and first of all, I want to thank Evergreen and the partners, Open North, the Government of Canada, University of Calgary, and the City of Calgary. It's extremely important that we work on these type of initiatives together and have opportunities to do so in the City of Calgary. I am the councillor for Ward 5, in which, does anybody know where Ward 5 is? Yeah, there you go. Northeast part of the city. So if you came from out of town, you landed on a plane in Ward 5. It's the most diverse part of the city. We're two-thirds of our population. English and French is not their first language. So people in Ward 5 are from all over the world. And I think the Smart Cities Initiative will have many great opportunities to engage and build more of an inclusive city and be able to connect with many of those folks who live there. I want to take a moment to thank all of you for being here at the Calgary Idea Camp, where I believe we can develop great relationships and really work together to foster innovative ideas that benefit our communities. So if you're from out of town, welcome to Calgary. I am an alumni of EVDS, and it's the first time being in this space, and what a beautiful space it is, and I think this is a great opportunity moving forward to do more of these events here. Our smart cities and technological advancements in urban areas are the way of the future. We have access to so much data, and through our various partnerships, many of these advancements are changing our society, the way we live, work, play, and learn. Municipalities across the world and Canada are facing tough issues. Moving forward, it is a passion of mine to find common sense solutions using out-of-the-box thinking. For me, when I first started on this path of learning more about smart cities, I mean, this is a whole, there's so many things going on with smart cities and so much to learn. But for me, it's, you know, the way I think of some of the basics of it, it's about, first of all, how do we collect the data that we intend to use? How do we store that data? How do we analyze that data? And then how do we use that to make real great policy decisions moving forward? So that's kind of where I start and end. And there's so much more than that to it, but I think in a broad way of thinking, that's the way I look at it. Data is a powerful asset that we need to harness. With the correct data, we can better manage and more efficiently at monitoring and managing traffic. Our transportation systems, power plants, water networks, waste management, crime detection, schools, libraries, hospitals, and much more. Smart cities are also allowing cities to reduce costs, consumption, and our global footprint at the same time increases connectivity between our citizens, government, and everything in between. There are many world-class cities that have taken the lead in this space, including Singapore, Dubai, Madrid, Barcelona, Stockholm, Helsinki, and New York. And we are excited to put Calgary and all of our partners on the map as well. I'm excited about the possibility of Calgary working with our partners, both publicly and privately, to push the envelope on technological development in the smart city space and take us to the world stage. Smart cities cannot be built in a vacuum, and co-creating is essential, which is a big focus of this event. Moving forward, we must focus on collaborating between government, academia, industry, and our citizens to create solutions together. Once again, thank you to all of the amazing and diverse people in the audience today. I hope all of you will take everything you learned today back to your communities for further engagement and dialogue. We need to spur regional collaboration and keep the conversation moving forward. Thank you.